Right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries. Today we have a case of John William Leonard. And this is an unexplained death. This man was murdered in the 70s because he was a taxi cab driver. He showed up to pick up his fare, and someone came with a duffel bag and shot him 3 or 4 times in the back of the head. This is an unexplained death. Who shot this man? In 1970, at a resort in Monroe County, Pennsylvania. If you have any information, please contact these places right here. Make a mental note. Take a picture in your mind. Leave a comment on the comment section on this video. You too could help solve a mystery. Like I said before, this is an unexplained death of this man, John William Leonard. Now let's get into the case. John William Leonard, as we do here on the show. This is live. We don't edit. You get a lot of views there, probably. Okay, every once in a while we make a mistake. That was one time right there. As we always do, we're going to draw him and tell you about his case. This is the case of John William Leonard out of Monroe County, Pennsylvania, Barrett Township. State police continue to investigate this 53-year-old Monroe County cold case. It's also a cold case, unexplained death. In Barrett Township, Monroe County, state police are continuing their investigation into the homicide of a taxi driver in Monroe County. Like I told you on the intro, he was called to pick up a fare. A person called him, told him to pick him up at this resort. On September 8, 1970, John William Sr. was found shot to death in his taxi cab on the grounds of the Buck Hill Falls Lodge in Barrett Township. There is rumors that say that this lodge is haunted. There is no truth to these rumors, though. It is not haunted. It was a very nice, upscale resort, but it was in the middle of nowhere. This could have led to the demise of this man because it was so secluded. But then again, I did watch documentaries and podcasts saying that this place was a hopping place in the 1970s. And there should have been a lot of witnesses, especially someone shot in the head. We can get into more of that later. A short time prior, officials say the taxi service Leonard worked for received a call from a white male requesting a ride from Buck Hill Falls to Mountainhome, approximately 5 miles away. Leonard left the taxi garage in Cresco, Pennsylvania. for the 2 mile ride to Buck Hills Falls Lodge. There was an eyewitness. It was an employee of the Buck Hills Falls Lodge. He told police they saw Leonard drive toward the main building on the hotel property. When he stopped the vehicle, officials say a white male with dark hair between the ages of 30 to 40 approached the vehicle wearing a blue-green windbreaker, dark pants, and dark frame glasses. The male was carrying a Globe Store bag. Now, they did research on what a Globe Store bag is, and the podcasters said that this was a department store, specifically in Scranton in the 70s, which is about 40 minutes from this location. It was like a Kmart or a Costco or something like that. That's what this Globe department store was. And the guy approached the taxi with one in his hand. There's speculation saying that there was a gun in here with a silencer, which could have very well been, and that's why no one heard anything. There's also speculation saying that this man may have known John, and the employee just saw this, and then he went back to his work, which means he looked away for a matter of minutes, and then John was shot. So the guy with the bag may not have been anybody at all. He may have known him, and then the real killer may have come out of the bushes. We don't know. That's why this is an unexplained death. And this is on here because it is a mystery cold case. 53-year-old cold case, to be exact. John William Leonard Sr. was 52 years old at the time of his murder and the father of five loving children. Now, he was a serviceman in his earlier years. He was a prisoner of war in World War II, I believe. They didn't say where he was a prisoner of war at, but they said he was a prisoner of war. And when he got back to the States, he did a lot of odd jobs, and taxi cab driving was his main gig, though. Also said that he had some marital problems. At the time of the murder, he was having marital problems with his wife, and they were in the process of separating, which is important to note. He did these taxicab drives and other odd jobs to support his five children, which he had custody of. The wife was no longer in the picture. So he had to get his hustle on and do this main gig and do other side hustles. So these are all important things to note in this case. Like I said, though, I don't solve them, I just draw them. these all have bearings on this case, these little factoids that I'm giving you. Pennsylvania State Police are interested in speaking with anyone that has information on this case and are offering a $5,000 reward. Investigators are interested in hearing from any waiters or bartenders who were working at the Buck Hill Falls Lodge during August-September of 1970. And that Buck Hill Falls Lodge is no longer in existence. It's been torn down. Probably because it was associated with this murder. This was a huge case in the 1970s. And the five children, two of them were twins, and the twins to this day are in their 50s and 60s, and they are still trying to get answers for their dad's mysterious, unexplained death. They are very vigilant with the police, but the reports say that the police are not diligent and vigilant back with them. They do not reciprocate. So that again adds another hurdle in this case. Also, another interesting side note is their mother, his wife, John William Leonard's wife, was killed in a car crash investigating a lead on this John William Leonard's death. That is very interesting to note. That is very important to note. She was killed in a car crash investigating a lead or a tip that was called in by someone, and they said she had to meet them, and she was killed on the way to meeting them about the tip. So the twins, who have become amateur detectives themselves, claim that their mother was killed also and connected to this case. So if this is true, this is not just one cold case, but this is a double cold case that are connected to each other. So even more complicated to solve, I would imagine. Anyone knows any information on this case? It's a Northeast Pennsylvania case. Please comment on the comment sections or contact the information I provided you in the beginning of this video. I will put it on at the end of this video also. This man had no history of being in trouble with any kind of law or anything. And after this happened, folks in Barrett Township started packing heat, not letting their kids stay out past dark, changed the whole landscape of this area in the 70s. So this was a wildly huge exposed case. And the feds took over it from small town police, who were originally on the scene, but feds not too long afterwards took over the reins, because this was just a small town and they were not used to dealing with a murder. There was a witness. The only witness was able to provide a sketch too of what the person looked like, and I do not have access to that sketch right now at the moment, but I can tell you it kind of looked like the sketch from the Zodiac. But now I'm not saying that he was killed by the Zodiac. Don't misconstrue what I'm saying, but the sketch kind of looks like the sketch from the Zodiac. That's all. Thought it was strange. Well, when you do a lot of these cases, you remember sketches. Especially me, being an artist, I would be inclined to remember the sketches. The twins are getting older too, and they want closure to this case, and I don't blame them. It's been 53 years. They were teenagers when it happened. Someone took their father from them way too early. Way too early for comfort, if you ask me. The police have not cooperated with them much. There is new people on the cases, and they're still, the twins say they're still getting the runaround, which is sad. You never want to see the family members suffer. There had, but also this, the gun that was used was kind of like one of those guns that they used to keep on their legs in the old days. They used to pull them out real quick. And those sons of bitches are loud, so someone had to have heard something. There has to be more than just one witness. Had to be more than one witness. This is what the twins are banking on. Someone coming forward, saying what they know. Especially like the police said, waiters, bartenders at the resort. Someone had to have heard something. Unless in that Globe Store bag there was like a silencer. We don't know. That could be a possibility. No one knows. It's a cold case, guys. But the cold cases are only one good clue away from being solved. That's what Ken Maine says. I listen to a lot of Ken Maine's. I think he's really good. And he's right. Cold case is only one good clue away from being solved. Guys, this is the case of John William Leonard. We're about through with this one. Another case down. Another case drawn. But not solved. Unexplained death of John William Leonard. Please give these places a contact, especially crimestoppers.com or pacrimestoppers.com. Anyone has any information, please contact these places, or if you have a tip, leave a message on the comment line on this video. Once again, true believers, I'm John. This is the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries. Peace out, true believers.